Welcome to the online tutorial for Vidya Bhavan Higher Secondary School. This video is for class 10 biology. In this video, I will continue with the chapter continuity of life. Okay. So let's start with the chapter continuity of life. In today's video, I will start with the topic mitosis. Mitosis. It is a type of cell division. Where does it occur? I have already told you. It occurs in our body cells. Okay? In our body cells. It is also termed as indirect cell division. Why indirect? Because the nucleus divides by producing spindle fiber. The nucleus does not divide directly. Rather, the nucleus divides by producing the spindle fiber. That is why indirect cell division. And it is also termed as equation of cell division. Why equation of cell division? Because from one mother cell, the two equal number of daughter cells are being produced. That is why it is termed as the equation of cell division. That means the mother cell and the daughter cells are qualitatively and quantitatively equal. Okay. Now, there are some characteristics of mitosis. First characteristic, it is termed as the equation of division. Just now I have said you, that as the daughter cells which are produced from the mother cell are equal in quality and quantity, that's why it is termed as equational division. Next, it is also known as indirect cell division. Just told you that it is dividing the nucleus by producing the spindle fiber. It does not divide the nucleus directly, rather it divides the nucleus by producing the spindle fiber. That is why it is termed as indirect cell division. Number 3, it is called somatic cell division. You tell me why it is called somatic cell division. Because it is taking place in the body cells. That is why somatic cell division. Next is that by this process, one mother cell will be producing two daughter cells. Number 5, the daughter cells have same chromosome number to that of the mother cell as well as same phenotype like the mother cell. That is, the daughter cells are qualitatively and quantitatively equal with that of the mother cell. So, this whole process of mitosis and its different stages can be categorized or can be considered into two states. What are the two states? First is that karyokinesis or nuclear division. Second is that cytokinesis or cytoplasmic division. Okay, so these are the two steps. Now, karyokinesis means the process by which the nucleus of mother cell is divided into two daughter nuclei through four stages: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. That is termed as a karyokinesis. That means this karyokinesis is having four stages: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. So, by these processes or by these stages, the karyokinesis is being completed. So, first we will see about the prophase. Here, the chromosomes will condense, will get shortened, and will thick. The condensed chromosomes, why the chromosomes are getting condensed? Due to the loss of water, due to dehydration of water. Number 3, chromosome is coiled by spiralization, forming series of beads of structure, bead-like structures. Chromosomes getting coiled, producing bead-like structures. And those structures are termed as chromomere. Now, each chromosome consists of two chromatids, that is the two arms, okay, which are held together by the centromere. Now, during early prophase, the chromosomes are evenly distributed in the nucleoplasm. But as the prophase progresses, the chromosomes migrate towards the nuclear membrane. Obviously, towards the nuclear membrane, the chromosomes will appear. Nucleus and nuclear membrane gradually will disappear. Otherwise, the nuclear division cannot take place. In animal cells, the centrioles duplicate and move towards the opposite poles to form the spindle fiber. Okay, next is that number 9, The movement of centriole occurs due to pushing apart by growth of the spindle fibers between them. That is, the movement of the centrioles that is occurring. You just see if this is the cell and these centrioles gets duplicated into two in number. So at first over here it is being present. Now then what will happen? These two centrioles will start to move to each of the poles. And why they are moving? Because of the spindle fiber. This spindle fiber will actually, that is it produced between these two centrioles, will actually push these two centrioles to the two opposite poles. Okay. And during this mitosis, the centriole, during the cell division, the centriole producing aster. Okay, it looks like a sun. The aster, that is the coming out of the spindle that are coming out from the centriole. The aster, the centrioles, and the spindle fiber. Okay, all of these three togetherly, they are termed as mitotic apparatus or achromatic figure. Okay, so these are the processes or events that are taking place in prophase. Now coming to the metaphase. Metaphase means what? A diamond shaped structure is formed during the metaphase, which we call it as the spindle. You see, here the chromosome are being arranged in the equatorial plane, and these chromosomes are being attached with the spindle fibers, and so you see the diamond shaped structure is being appearing. Two pointed ends of the spindles are called poles, and the central part is known as equator. See, these two are the poles, and this is the equator, the middle part. Okay, number three, the spindle is formed of spindle fibers that are made of fibrin protein. I have told you when I was giving you the role of the cell organelles in the cell division, these microtubules and centrioles, they form the spindle fiber, and this spindle fiber is actually formed of a protein termed as tubulin. Okay, number four, the chromosomes begin to proceed towards the equator. You see, the chromosomes are arranged in the equator. Okay, and at this stage they become so dense and they are becoming so dehydrated, shortened and thickened that they can be easily identified under the microscope. Number five, the centromere is attached with the short chromosomal fiber and the arms are directed towards the poles. You see, this centromere is attached with the spindle fiber and these arms are directed towards the poles. Similarly with this portion also. Okay, number six, in plant cells, the orientation of chromatids on equatorial plane is random, but in animal cells, a pattern of orientation occurs when larger chromosomes are attached at the periphery of the cell plate and the smaller chromosomes are placed at the central part. That means, in case of animal cells, there is an orientation of this arrangement. In case of plant cells, there is no such orientation. Now, coming to the anaphase. This anaphase is the third stage. It is the important stage and is the very shortest stage. Here what happens? The centromeres of the chromosomes divide and the two chromatids of each pair separate. After separation they are called daughter chromosomes. That's why here you can see, I have told you that in case of mitosis, the doubling of the content of the mother cell will take place. That means the chromosomes, they are also are doubled. That means that this in one spindle fiber there are two chromosomes are attached, forming an XX structure. Similarly over here. So when these in the anaphase, what will happen? These are here.
observe the opposite phase. Okay, here the chromosomes uncoil and despiralize. Okay, that means in case of prophase, at first the chromosomes spiraled itself. Now here the chromosomes will despiralize itself. Okay, nucleoplasm, cytoplasm are dehydrated. That means gained water. Nucleolus will reappear. Spindle fibers will be destroyed or disorganized. In animal cells, the astral rays will be disappearing. Apart from this, the nuclear membrane will also reappear. So these are the characteristic features of different phases of mitosis. Okay, in the next video, we will continue with the next part of the chapter. Thank you, everyone.